Hello students, today I am going to discuss with you a very interesting and important topic, laundry and laundry operations. You know very well, laundry plays a very important role in all the hotels as it takes care of various linens of the various departments as well as upkeepments of the uniform of all the staffs. Now laundry is having a very intimate relation with the housekeeping, as housekeeping maintains the linens and uniforms of all the staff. Whenever any linens and uniforms are gets dirty, it has been handed over to the housekeeping for sending to the laundry. Housekeeping send to the laundry, laundry washed it and back to the housekeeping. Housekeeping check all the linens and uniform and dispatch to the respective department and staff. So unit 4, laundry and laundry operations, I have divided into 6 subsections. Section A, that is principle of laundry as well as qualities of good laundries. Section B, that is types of laundries along with their advantages and disadvantages. Section C, layout of the laundries. Section D, laundry operations. Section E, the equipments needed for the laundry operations. And the final section, that is a guest personal laundry. Now I am starting with the section A, that is principle of laundry. Removal of dirt and stains from the linen, that can be the one of the principle of laundry. That means the main work of the laundry is to removal of dirt and stains from the linens. Restoring linens articles to their original appearance for the as far as possible. That means making the linen in such a way so that they should be back in their original position. Now I am going to explain about the qualities of laundries. Number one, careful handling of the linens article when laundry. So when the articles or the linens are getting washed, it should be handled very carefully, or I will say that it should be handled by the professional washman. Number two, correct processes should be used for the suitable laundry. That means during the laundry operations, there are lots of process one after another, and you have to maintain the correct process to make the all the linens and uniform clean and clear. Number three, white materials are kept white and excessive bleaches should not be used. So while cleaning of the white material, you can use the bleaches and softeners, and you can say the excessive bleaches should not be used, which may damage the linens. Number four, proper counting and records maintenance to avoid the shortage of linens. Every day, you know, the huge quantity of linens are laundered. So it should, the proper track record should be maintained in order to prevent the pilferage and shortage of the linens. And number five, sound policies regarding the damage or loss of property. That means over here, you should have a proper sound policies in order to prevent or damages of the linens and uniforms. Section D, laundry operations. Now look over here about this figure very carefully. First, we are just removing of the dirty linens from the rooms. Now it has been collected into the laundry bags and transferred to the soil linens to the laundry with the help of laundry trolleys. Next, over in the laundry, the first work is the sorting. Now what is sorting? All the linens are collected together. So first you have to sort it, that is a towel separately, bed sheet separately, the pillow slip separately. So you have to sort it. Next comes over here. After that, you have to weight the linens. Now, why you have to weight the linens? Because the washing machine is having the certain capacity to for washing of the linens. So if it is overweight or underweight, it may damage the machine. So after you having the weighting is correctly, you put the dirty linens in the washing machine and for washing purpose. So see over here, it is for we put the linens in the washing machine for washing purpose. Next, from here we take it to the extraction in a hydro extractor. Now, what is the function of hydro extractor? It is the function is so to remove extract the water from the linens. So only 50 to 75% of the water is removed from the hydro extractor, not 100%. So then from here we have to put the linens to the dryer. In the dryers, you having the after putting the linens in the dryer, we just switch on the hot air which blows into the linens and make the linens totally dry. Next, after that, we just put the handover to the pressing pressing sections of the laundry where you have to press it. So after pressing, you have to fold the linens. So after pressing, folding of the linens is done, and finally transporting to the various departments. So this is the entire functions of the laundry operations. Section B. Now, there are two types of laundries. One is off-premises laundry, another is on-premises laundry. Now, on-premises laundry, you know very well, the laundries which are located inside the hotel. That means the hotels having their own laundries. And off-premises laundry, that means the commercial laundries. That means the hotels have to depend on the others. Laundries, they don't have their own laundries in their inside the hotels. Now I'm going to discuss about the advantages and disadvantages of on-premises laundries. Number one, advantages of on-premises laundry: time taking for laundry is reduced because transportation is reduced. As you know, the hotel in the laundry is located inside the hotel, so it takes a very less time for transportation. Number two, linens are ready available, especially in case of emergency requirements. So during the time of emergency, within 5 minutes intimation, the linens can be get ready and it has been can be dispatched to the various sections because the laundry is located inside the hotel. Now, the disadvantages of off-premises laundry is that huge amount of money should be invested for construction of laundries. Number two, excessive water, new staffs are required for the laundry operations, electricity cost, the operation cost, cost of maintenance of the machines, cost of laundry agents are huge. So huge amount of money should be invested for the laundry operation in the on-premises laundry. Now I am going to discuss about the off-premises laundry. Off-premises laundry is the one advantage is that the hotel don't have their own laundry. Now, so the space is safe, electricity is safe, huge amount of water is safe, there is no personal required for laundry operation. so their salary is saved. Number two is that over here, that is, it has been the total responsibility is depend on the commercial laundries. So the hotel never crack their head to run the laundry operation. Section C, that is the layout of the laundries. First comes about the doors. The doors should be wide enough so that all the laundry trolleys and the dirty linen trolleys can get inside the laundry easily. Next comes to the walls. The walls should be sound absorbent, because when the machines are running, the sound shouldn't go outside of the laundry. Next comes about the floor. The floor should be strong enough to prevent from regular wear and tear. In a laundry, there should be sufficient water supplies, because the main ingredients of washing is water. There should be sufficient electricity inside the laundry, because all the machines are running with the help of electricity. So if these are if you having these items sufficient, it is very easy to run the laundry operation. Section E, the various equipments and agents which are required for washing of the clothes. The students, I am going to explain you about the various equipment, laundry machines and agents which are used daily for washing of the clothes. First comes about the equipments. In the laundry, we have seen the big washing machines, we have seen the hydro extractors, you face the dryers, you face the various types of iron. Now, in this, the washing machines which are used in the commercial laundries, they are very huge and they are called the industrial washing machines. At a time, they can use that 100 to 200 kgs. They can wash the 100 to 200 kgs of linen. Next comes about the hydro extractor. Hydro extractor, hydro extractors are the function of hydro extractor is to extract the water after the washing of the linen. So once the linen has been washed, it has from the washing machine, it has been put into the hydro extractor for extracting of the water. Next comes to the dryers. The hydro extractor can extract 50 to 70% of the water. So for that reason, it has been transferred to the dryer. In a dryer, when it is on, the hot air blows to the linen, which makes the linen entirely dry. After that, when the linen has been come out, now they are used sending for the pressing. There are big pressing machines, pressers are used in the laundry, and calendaring machines are also used. So these are the very basic equipments required in the laundry operations. Now I am going to demonstrate about the various agents used in the laundry. First comes the water, which is very, very important for the laundry operation and washing of the linen. Without water, the laundry operation is totally incomplete and impossible. Next comes the detergent. Another most important detergent, it is also used for washing of the clothes, for the removal of dirt from the linens. We are having, that is, a whitener which makes the linens very bright, and it makes the linen to bring its glaze. We are having the using the starch which helps the linen after washing to make the crease in the linen and makes the prominent ironing of the linens. and finally we are having that is a stain removing agent which removes the various stains from the linens. So these are the common agents which are used in the laundry in the for cleaning of the linens. The last subsection of this topic laundry is guest personal laundry. Now, in every room, laundry bag along with the laundry sheet is given. That means, if the guest wants to give his laundry, his linens or personal dress for washing, they are always welcome to send it to the laundry. Now, inside the guest room, we are having the laundry bags where the guest can put all his personal dirty linens. Now, every morning, the valet used to come and collect the check the linens, guest personal linen, and takes the linen and take it to the laundry. After washing it properly at the evening, it has been again sent it to the guest room. And the guest will check it and sign the receipt for the payment. So this is all about your guest personal laundry. Now in this chapter, students, we have learned about the principle of laundry, qualities of laundry, types of laundries along with their advantages, disadvantages, the layout of the laundries. Next comes the laundry operations, the various equipments used for the laundry, the various agents used for the laundry, and finally the guest personal laundry. Thank you.